Digital communication playlist. Here in this session, I'll explain Huffman coding procedure and example on ternary code. I have already explained Huffman coding procedure in last example. So in this example, first we will solve this example step by step, and then how we can use that in ternary code that we will be doing. So let us have this question. A source produces a symbol S1, S2 up to S9. Construct trinary and quaternary. In next session, I will explain quaternary. In this session, I will explain ternary Huffman coding by moving symbols as high as possible. And also find efficiency and variance of coding. Probability of symbols are 0.11 for all. So let us solve this. So first step is to arrange all symbols in ascending order with probability. So let us mention symbols. And here there is probability. So symbols are from S1 to S9 and probability are equal. Now this is what we are solving for ternary. So we need to take group of 3. So here this 3 that we are considering, this is assigned with 0, this is assigned with 1, and this is assigned with 2. So for ternary there are 3 values, 0, 1 and 2, and addition of that is 0.33. so we can move it to as high as possible, and that will come here 0.33. now this will come here 0.11, this will come here 0.11, this will come here 0.11, this will come here, this is 0.11, this will come here 0.11, and this will come here 0.11. now again take lowest 3 assigned with 0, 1 and 2 and move it to as high as possible. So we will be moving it to maximum. The reason is it is 0.33. now this 0.33, this 0.11, this 0.11 and this 0.11. now again add this 3 assign bit with 0, 1 and 2. Move it to as high as possible. So it will come here 0.33. this 0.33 will come here, and this 0.33 will come here. Now we can assign 0, 1 and 2 with this. That is how we can solve this basic problem. Now we need to write down code word for each. So code word that we will be solving step by step. Let me mention here code word and code length. So code word and length, and here there is symbol. So symbols are S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6, S7, S8 and S9. Now let us have code word first. So just go in forward direction first. And assign code in reverse. So 0, 0. Then there is no bits. So 0, 0. Now for S2, go in forward direction first. In code word that will be 0, 1. For S3, go in forward direction first. So 0, 2. For S4, go in forward direction first. So that is having code 1, 0. For S5, go in forward direction first. 1, 1. For S6, go in forward direction first. So 1, 2. Now for S7, go in forward direction first. 2, 0. For S8, just go in forward direction first. 2, 1. For S9, just go in forward direction first. So 2, 2. So length of code that is 2 for all. Length of code that is 2 for all. Now let us solve all those data step by step so it will be more clear. So first is entropy. Entropy is summation Pi log of base 2 1 by Pi. Here probability is 0.11 for all, so we don't need any change. It will be 9 times 0.11 log of base 2 1 divided by 0.11, and if you calculate this, I have already done it, so I'm just mentioning it, 3.1525 bits per symbol. Second is code word length. So that is summation PINI. Code word length is 2 for all codes. So 9 times 0.11 into 2. If you solve this, you will be finding it is 1.98 bits per symbol. Now let us solve efficiency first. So efficiency, that is H divided by L log of base 2 R. Now we have solved H, that is 3.1525. L, that is 1.98 log of base 2 R. For this is what we are solving for ternary code, and for ternary code R is 3. And if you solve this again, you can resimplify this. It could be 3.1525 divided by 1.98 into log 3, and this base 2 that will go in numerator, log 2. That is how even you can solve. And if you calculate this efficiency, you'll be finding it is 1, means 100%. It will be 1, means in terms of percentage it will be 100. Now see, as if you check variance formula, then variance that we have already calculated, summation Pi Ni minus L whole square, that is what the basic formula that I have already explained you in last session. I hope that you have remembered it. Here probability and average length. Average length is 1.98. So it is happening equally for all. So 9 times probability, that is 0.11 into Ni, that is 1.98 minus L, so 1.98 minus 2 whole square, So I'm just keeping this for you as a question. You just write down that in comment so that I can know you are solving it or not. So just write down this answer in comment. I have not solved it, so I want answer from you. You just calculate this and give me answer. Thank you so much for watching this video. In next video, I'll explain quaternary code by using Huffman coding. So that will be a little more interesting. Stay tuned. You will enjoy it definitely. Thank you so much for watching. Keep watching videos, sharing it with your friends, and give me your valuable suggestions. Definitely I'll look at your suggestions, and probably I'll place videos in future based on your suggestions. Thank you so much for watching this video.